Hey YouTube, what's going on? It's Old and Grey BMX and a Game of Power unboxing. This time it's Dan's GT. It's an Albert Ricardo 2021 model. So let's get on with it. Well, it's a colour.
She's having none of it, she's gone. Do you want to
Let's see.
Yeah.
I've had a couple of these, and they don't really change them over the years, other than the colours. We'll go through the spec in a minute. Let's just get it unwrapped. I've got a 2020 one of these at home, which is a pink colour. This is quite nice in the green. Green LP5 tyres. Hopefully they've got some air in, which they haven't, so that's going to be a problem.
I've got a pump.
That's in the spot. This retails at $380, I think. There's two models, there's a comp and a team. This one's the team. I think the comp is about $450. There's not a lot of difference, other than I think it's a bit more chromoly in frame. So on this one, if I'm to drive, I think the main triangle is chromoly, and the rears are high tensile steel. And on the team, how much was this, Dan?
I'm just checking. You messaged me tonight. $439.
So this is the higher grade one, so this one is $439, and I think everything except for the seat stays is chromoly. They're just high tensile steel, I think. I might be wrong. But the front triangle is definitely chromoly. And the plastic bollocks, I think, so it's a whole bunch of plastic. This one came from Skate Pro, no, Source, was it Source?
Skate Pro.
It was Skate Pro, so it's been imported. Took, I think, nearly 2 weeks to get it, which was quite slow. But they seem to get stuck in customs. Normally Skate Pro are quite quick than that. We've got sealed bearings, which is a good sign. I think these are single wall on the front and a double wall on the back. So GTR LP5 tyres look really good in the black and green. it's more like an ice cream colour.
Do you want them?
What's that?
When my new ones come, do you want
them? No. So the idea is to get this built up, and then we'll go down to around some of the local spots, and then get them down to London, depending on the weather. It looks a bit great out here. Yeah. Sunday looks probably some of the packaging there.
But underneath they're going to scratch.
Yeah. One of my favourite things on the GT, if it comes left hand drive out the factory, now I've got the Carlo lights to right left hand drive. It is one of my favourite features. I like to ride left hand drive. Sunday still set up to right hand drive, but by the end of the week it will be left hand drive. I've got a matte black or satin black bottom half and a translucent green. You can see the heat welds there, and then of course the stays there, of course the bridge. Put the U-brake at the top. I don't think it's a branded one, but I know that Dan will be upgrading this as we go along. And then it looks like the graphics are identical to the year before. So I've got the same ones, exactly the same stickers. The only thing that looks like it's changed is the colourway. Sealed rear, again, it's good for the price, from a value for money point of view, for less than 500 it comes in with quite a good market price, quite a good spec price. I know, I think the We The People one of its price only comes with one tube primarily. We've got the canvas Albert Ricardo signature seat, really nice seat, I love this seat, I've got two of them. Okay, let's get it built up. We'll use the multi-tool again. Oh wait, hold on, we're missing parts.
What's that? A multi-tool.
That's the multi-tool. Dan could have been opening all these boxes while I was talking. Then we get a 25 minute video that way there. So we've got a crappy front brake, if you want that fitted on. Spare brake cable, might as well keep that. Hey look, Dan, you get a chain guard.
Oh.
Yeah, and it's left hand drive specific. Spare brake lever. At least it's aluminium, that crappy one we got with a Sunday. We'll keep that as a spare, they're always handy.
You need to be jealous.
And some reflector brackets that it needs.
Can you take the reflectors off the wheels as well?
We'll take the reflectors off the wheels as well. Nobody needs reflectors in their lives. It's not a Brompton. And here we have more reflectors. They should be GT branded, yeah, they are GT branded pedals. GT owner's manual, no, I know this is generic, even though it says GT on it, and I love GT, sorry. Sorry, nothing. And a sticker. Dad, put that on his Christmas tree. I know these pedals don't last very long. They're a bit rough out of the box. I think they're well made, or just some Chinese crap, but they'll be alright for today. I'm sure it'll be spending his money on. Some B12s or some Odyssey Twisted or something. So I take all the reflectors off, mainly because of dignity, really. Nobody needs that sort of negativity crap. Let's get this going up. That wasn't meant to happen.
Should I turn off the Alexa? For the music?
No, they can't.
Music and YouTube don't mix well.
Yeah, I might get a content strike.
Alexa, turn off.
How much is that mummy tool? How much is that?
£50. I think it's worth it because you get pretty much everything you need, including a chain tool and the socket for the pegs.
So, what's the first thing to upgrade on that pedal?
I don't know, what would be the first thing to upgrade? What do you think? I've got a body stem. These stems aren't great. Yeah, maybe the cranks, pedals, chainring, sorry, sprocket, bars. Just get to feel, get a good feeling for it, and then you can see. We'll swap after that. That's a GT branded stem, but they're not very good, they're just cheap aluminium ones. But if you on Facebook Marketplace, you can pick up a decent Shadow or a Sunday or Wheel of People, something like that, for a tenner. That's if the postman ever brings it. We ordered some wheels for this 2 weeks ago when they were sent, and couriers reckon they delivered it yesterday, but they're lying because they didn't. So thanks to my Hermes, you just lost my Odyssey wheels. Gets the Allen key set out in front of that. Gets the Allen key set out in front of that bag.
You've got some inner tubes.
Yeah.
You see? In the front.
Huh?
You see in the front.
Yeah.
Any scratches aren't have to mark you down on the review.
The bars are shifted.
I like the seat.
Yeah, the seat's really nice.
Is that the one with the Allen key in the seat?
Yeah, pivotal. Donkey goes down there. One thing I noticed with this finish is it does rust really fast.
Death.
Well, mine did anyway, but then mine was left in someone's garden for what looked like the best part of a year.
Respray, yeah.
You know, it's a translucent finish, it would just be not worth it. I kind of, you know, I kind of dig it, it's alright. It's only got rust spots in it in some places. We'll have a look at that bike in another video. I've upgraded that quite a lot, put some cold match wheels with shallow Raptor hubs on it. Upgraded the cranks, tyres, bars, pretty much everything on it. One thing I noticed when I built these before is the cranks don't come done up tight. So not the wedge ones, they're the pinch ones. So if you get one, make sure you check all the bolts on this. I'll check the center one. These are built in seat clamps on this, they're not separate ones, that's one thing you can't upgrade. So I welded onto the frame. But they are GT branded, so that's pretty good. Okay, that's good. Let's figure out how to get this wheel cut off.
I might have some more grips upstairs.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Yeah.
Just to grip the next one.
Should you shoot through them all grips?
And they eventually bring out 2022 ones. This is it's November 21 at the moment. And GT still haven't released any information on their 2022 models. But when they do, I'll probably pick up a 2022 version. Just because they're cheap, you can do them up, you can upgrade them really easily for not a lot of money. And it's a good looking bike, good quality. And there you have it, the 2021 GTR Mercado Team Edition.